television time for the following has been purchased. Any comments, recommendations, or opinions in this program do not necessarily reflect the views of KTXA-TV or its agencies.
Hello, I'm Robert Tilton, and we are here in the Holy Land of Miracles, broadcasting to you live via satellite. And the next 60 minutes we have dedicated to miracle prayers. Why not? Here in the Land of Miracles. And I'm standing right now in the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus Christ prayed the will of God. Did you know that it's God's will for you to prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers? That's 3 John 2. If you have any kind of need, a lost loved one, trouble with your finances, maybe marriage problems, I don't care what kind of problems that you have, the next 60 minutes we dedicate to mountain-moving prayers here in the Holy Land of Miracles. Don't go away.
Success in Life presents a live telecast from Israel. Robert Tilton, live from the Holy Land of Miracles. Join us from Israel for this satellite broadcast of Success in Life. Now, here's Robert Tilton.
Yes, here we are in the Land of Miracles, and I'm seated here in the Garden of Gethsemane, right here at the foot of the Mount of Olives, where Jesus Christ departed and said that he was going to come back. And yes, he's come back by the power of his Holy Spirit. This is the very garden where Jesus prayed with his disciples, where Peter fell asleep. And Jesus continued the night in prayer, and he was praying that the will of God be done. Can you imagine Jesus making intercession and praying for you? Yes. It says that he is alive today. The Bible says that he's just the same today as he was yesterday, and he will be the same tomorrow. Hebrews 13:8. In this very site, here at the foot of the Mount of Olives, it's called Gethsemane, or where they pressed the olive fruit and made it oil. And they made the olive oil right here along these ruins in this site. Behind me is the walls of Jerusalem and the Eastern Gate that's blocked up now. But there's a day coming when those stones are going to blast away, and Jesus Christ is going to walk once again back into the holy city as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Did you know that we are living in the last days, and that Jesus is alive this very moment, and miracles still happen today? He said in John 14, whatever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you shall ask anything in my name, or in the authority of my name, that will I do. Jesus said, up until now, you've asked nothing in my name. You've seen the miracles. You've seen the blind eyes open and the deaf hear and the lame walk. Now you, the believer, can pray in my name. Whatever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father will be glorified in the Son. Let me ask you a question. What kind of miracle do you need? What kind of adversity are you facing? I'm here broadcasting right this very moment. Many of you are watching me live. Some it's a little bit of a delay. But we are broadcasting this very moment here on the Holy Land of Miracles. This city, Jerusalem, is called the City of God, not just by man, but by the Bible. Isaiah 48:2 says it's the holy city. Think about it. This place is holy. It's dedicated, consecrated by God. God chose this city. The maker of the heavens and the earth chose this city, it says, to place his name there. Psalms 46:4 says that there's a spiritual river flows out of this place. Oh, we cannot see it with the natural eye, but there's power and there's an anointing. The presence of God is upon this place. How else could such a tiny little nation stay alive? In 1960s, they were surrounded by 20-some-odd nations. that wanted to totally annihilate them. But through an act of God, these nations were wiped out, pushed back, and a nation continued to live. Israel, it's a country of miracles, a land of miracles. What does that mean? That means that in the natural strength, they could never make it. But there's a God bigger than they are, that helps them through their adversities. Let me read to you from Psalms 110. The Lord will send forth out of Zion, and that's Mount Zion right over there, and the Lord will send forth out of Zion the rod of his strength. The rod of strength, the power and authority will come out of Zion. Yes, and he said, rule thou because of this power, rule in the midst of your enemies. That's what this country is doing. They are ruling in the midst of their enemies. They're surrounded by Syria, Jordan, Egypt. In the midst of this Middle East crisis, Saddam Hussein has tried to make them into a pawn. But I want you to know something. Just as there's natural adversities, Israel has been a type and shadow of the spiritual church. And just as there are adversities in this country, there's adversities in people's lives. This is your hour, and this is your day to receive deliverance. For you, there's power coming forth out of Zion for you to rule in the midst of your enemies. What kind of enemies are you facing right now? What kind of discouragement? For the next few minutes, we're going to be taking prayer requests. And after today's program, we're going to the upper room. We're going to where Jesus had communion with his disciples. And I want to take your prayer request. And I want to pray over your prayer request. Years ago, God visited me. I saw people in front of me as far as I could see, like this very moment you're in front of me. And I heard the Lord speak to me in an audible voice. And he said, many of my ministers pray for my people, but I want you to pray the prayer of agreement. Can you imagine God speaking to you? I didn't ask for it. It just happened. No, I didn't see him, but I heard him. He was like about 60 feet away. He said, many of my ministers pray for my people, but I want you to pray the prayer of agreement. And as people begin to come in front of me, I remember how that I touched their head, and every kind of hideous disease, incurable problems imaginable, they were healed and made whole instantly. God spoke to me to come to this country in the middle of the Middle East crisis, here in this little country, like a pawn in the midst of all of the adversities that are happening. God sent me here to take and have a revival right this very moment, a revival of prayer. Jesus said, whatever you ask in my name, that will I do. And here I am in the midst of Jerusalem, the city of God, the city of David, Mount Zion, a holy city, the place that God had chosen to put his name. Do you have lost loved ones right now that have never committed their life to Christ? I want to pray for them right now. Do you have lost loved ones? Maybe you have someone in the armed forces that's been moved to the Middle East. Maybe they're in the armed forces and you're concerned about them. After today's program, I want to take their prayer request and I want to agree with you in prayer. I'm going to do what God told me to do. Yes? Trust in the Lord your God, and so shall you be established. Yes, and believe his prophets, and so shall you prosper. For I have chosen this hour in these last days to birth a miracle in your life. If you will not just accept defeat, but if you will accept victory, my victory over adversities, over sickness and disease and lack, I will bring a miracle into your home. Didn't I say in the last days that I would place a glory cloud of protection over my assemblies and even over Mount Zion? Today, I want to bring peace in the midst of problems. I want to bring peace into your home. I want to bring an anointing upon your lost loved ones so that they can hear the truth and be delivered from drugs and alcohol. For today, saith God, if you will not draw back and harden your heart, if you will not draw back as the children of Israel of old did, but if you will rise up and say, yes, I need a miracle, and say, yes, I believe, O God, you sent your servant to me to agree with me in prayer. It will be your day of miracles, saith the Lord. For I have never run out of miracles, but my children stopped asking. Ask, saith the Lord, so you may receive and your joy be full. Thank you, Lord. There's an anointing on me today. There's power flowing through my hands and my arms and my eyes. I sense the glory of God all over this place. What we've done in Dallas, Texas, we've hooked up fax machines to fax your prayer request to me right here in Jerusalem. This very moment, our phone center in Dallas, Texas, at 214-620-6200. Our prayer ministers are standing by. It makes no difference what time of the day that it is. God just spoke a word to someone out there watching me. It touched your heart. And that still, small voice, I don't know who you are. In a moment, I will, because they're going to bring me your prayer request. And after today's program, I'm going to the upper room where Jesus and the disciples prayed, and I'm going to lay my hands in, as an act of agreement, and call and agree with you in prayer, breaking the powers of darkness off of your home. In the name of Jesus, rule. This is your day. This is your moment. This is a prophetic word for someone to rule in the midst of your enemies. Yes, my sister, in the midst of adversity, even as this little nation continues to go forth in the midst of her enemies, you are going to go forth and rule and reign in life as a king. That's the power of prayer. One puts a thousand to flight. But you and I together in Jesus' name, we're going to put the devil to flight. Father, you see that one that you have sent me to today. God, I know that I am not called by man or any denomination or any group or camp. But God, your hand came upon me and you have sent me to this country. You have sent me to this holy city, holy ground. And God, I know with all of my heart that this is a holy place. It's separated to you. And Father, you see that one, Kasiita Andanda de Bosoya, that's having problems in her marriage. You see that one that's having problems in his business. You see that lost loved one. You see that one, oh God, in the armed forces. Father, you told me to pray in agreement with your people. Kaba'i Santa, yes? And I said, pray ye one for another that you may be healed. If you will pray, saith the Lord, today I will hear from heaven and I will bring deliverance, for there shall come deliverance out of Mount Zion, saith the Lord. There shall flow a river of life to those that are thirsty, to those who are dry, to those who are weary. My power of scepter, my rule rod, saith God, will break the powers of darkness off of my people this day. If they will only believe, they will see the glory of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. It's a powerful prophetic word for someone watching me. It's not an accident. You and I are together. This is divine destiny. I want you to quickly call me right now. The fax machines, they wire the prayer request. Here's some coming in now. They wire the prayer request to me right this moment. Right this moment, the prayer requests are coming in. Someone watching that had a problem in their marriage, strife, someone near a divorce. We're going to pray after today's program. You need to act, though. That's a word to you. You heard that word. But you've got to do something. Paul said, faith without action. You believe it was a word for you, then you must have action. Just calling. Our phone number in Dallas, Texas at 214-620-6200.